Greetings, Jesus, Lord of the world. What a marvelous time, what a marvelous hour. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord make his face shine upon your life. My name is Yamkila Joseph, and God has called me in this time to become a prophetic voice. I want you to understand that God wants you to be very big. God wants to do great things in your life. So today I want to speak to you about something very important: outgrowing your environment. How to discover the new man in you. You know, in life, you ought to embrace change. Change, it is what affects everybody. Change affects nations, languages, and everybody. It does not matter how educated you are, it doesn't matter where you are, but you ought to go through a moment of change. And a moment of change, it is a moment that ought to be embraced by everybody. But before we get into deep in what God has just touched me to speak into your life right now as a prophetic word, let us go to the scriptures. Go with me right now in the book of 2 Kings, number 6, and verse, starting from verse number 1. The Bible says, "The sons of the prophet said to Elisha, 'Please notice that the place where we live under your supervision is too small for us. Let us go to Jordan, where we can each get a log and build ourselves a place there and live there.' 'Go,' he said." My God, the sons of the prophets, they are saying to the man, the prophet Elijah, that the place where we are in, it is now too small for us. Let us go beyond Jordan to a place where we can find ourselves logs and build ourselves houses there, so that each one of us may have a place. Then the prophet say, "Go." So the prophet is giving them the ability, say, "Go." Then if you read down and go down, you will see that they then ask him to go with them. Then later, you know the story. The Bible said that the ex-head begin to be lost. But what I've come to discover in life, family, is that growth is fundamental. Growth is what you ought to face, is what you ought to actually embrace in your life. There was a point where the sons of the prophets were comfortable with the place, but it happened that at this time they begin to see that the place no longer accommodates them. The place is no longer conducive for them. So they now voice out their cry to the prophet of God. They say, "Now, this place that you are supervising us in, it is now too small for us. Please let us go beyond Jordan. Let us go beyond Jordan and find a place where we can build ourselves good logs there." Now, family, I have come to understand that God never places you in a place for too long. When God places you in a place, he wants you to outgrow the place so that you can go close and so that you can go above Jordan. Now, the sons of the prophets, they understood that when a place no longer accommodates them, they didn't have to endure the place, but they had to move to a place where they could be able to be accommodated by that particular place. So today I want to speak about discovering the new man inside of you. Many of you today have discovered that you are no longer finding joy in what used to be fun before. You are no longer enjoying the habits that you used to enjoy before, the places and the environments that you used to enjoy before. Because when growth begins to come in your life, you begin to see differently. You begin to think differently. You begin to understand differently. Everything, you begin to perceive it in a different way. This shows that you are now beginning to outgrow your environment. And when growth begins to knock in your life, you begin to outgrow certain relationships. You begin to outgrow certain people, the people that you could identify with, the people that were so dear to your heart, they begin to become irrelevant in your life. They begin to not make sense anymore. The things that you used to understand, you begin not to understand anymore. Why? Because growth has come. Change is now knocking at your door. But I want you to be like the sons of the prophet. When change begin to come, they didn't reject the fact that they were no longer comfortable in a place that that used to give them comfort. But they voiced out their disagreement. They voiced out their cry to the prophet and say, we know that we were once comfortable in this place of supervision, but we are no longer comfortable anymore. We now say that this place is now too small for us. It used to be good, yes, but now it is too small for us. Let us go beyond Jordan so that we can go and build ourselves a new place. My friend, I want to say to you, don't be afraid to enter into the new territories. Don't be afraid into embarking into new journeys. Don't be afraid into starting new relationships. Don't be afraid into looking into new world, because God wants you to discover the new person in you. And when that person has been discovered, you will begin to find discomfort in the places where you used to be comfortable. You will begin to not understand the people that you used to understand before. But what I want to say to you, change will cost you. Change will cost you your friends. Change will cost you your environment. Change will cost you your family. Change will cost you people that used to love you. They will begin to reject you. People that used to understand you, they will begin to neglect you. They will begin to speak against you. Why? Because when change comes, you become irrelevant to certain people. You become a rejected person to certain people because they no longer identify with you. You know, certain people are so much comfortable with your old person that they are not ready to see the new person in you. They are so much comfortable with your poverty that they are not ready to see the prosperity in you. They are so much comfortable with your sickness that they are not ready to see the new healed person in you. Like the old Bartimaeus, remember, his friends looked at him as a blind Bartimaeus, but when he was crying unto Jesus that have mercy on me so that I can see again, the Bible said they shouted and say, shut up, you are making noise, the master is busy, the master does not want to hear from you. The same people who told him that the healer was passing by, they were now saying to him that don't shout to the healer, don't reach out to the healer. Why? Because they are so much comfortable to see him struggling. They are so much comfortable to see him blind that they don't want to see a Bartimaeus who can now see. They don't want to see a Bartimaeus who can now be healed. Why? Because certain people are so much comfortable to see your struggle that they're not ready to see your prosperity. They're not ready to see your change. They're not ready to embrace the new person in you. But my friend, I want to say to you, embrace the new person. Embark into the new journeys. Don't be ashamed of growing. Don't be ashamed of growing. It is better to lose people. It is better to lose environments. It is better to lose certain places where you used to find comfort than for you to settle for less, than for you to stand where you no longer belong. Embark into the new journeys. Remember, this place is no longer sufficient for us. But let us go before Jordan. Let us go after Jordan so that we can build a place. Let that vision expand. Let that dream expand. Let it grow your location. Let it grow your family. Let it grow your outgrow your friends. Because at the end of the day, you need to embark into that journey. Don't be afraid of taking the journey of faith. Don't be afraid of going to that place that you ought to go to. Because at the end of the day, you are a child of destiny. You need to embrace growth. Growth is going to cost you relationships. It's going to cost you people. It's going to cost you family. It's going to cost you certain kinds of environment. But at the end of the day, you better choose to grow than to remain settled on one place. I want to say to you right now, embrace the change. Remember, I love you so much. And I pray for you that God will give you the strength and the power to embrace that change. Stretch your hands towards me. Father, I pray that you give them the ability to embrace the change. The ability to know the new level in their lives. Let them discover the new man. Let them discover the new power that is within them. I decree and I declare that in this season, their eyes of understanding will be opened so they can embrace the change, so they can embrace what you are doing in their lives. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen and amen. My friend, I want you to continue to tuning in. I want you to continue subscribing into this channel. Continue to share and comment and tell us what it is doing in your life. And share it with a lot of people. Download the videos if you can. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord make his face shine upon your life. My name is Yamkila Joseph. Until I see you next time. Shalom.